Hi guys, welcome to my channel Team Techies. Firstly, I want to apologize that I haven't been uploading videos since last couple of weeks due to my exams that had been lined up. But yep, my exams are over and here I am with my new video. So before starting with this video, let's recap back that what we have learned from our previous video. From our first video, we learned that what is a programming language. From the second video, we learned how to download and install Anaconda Navigator and what is Jupyter Notebook and what are its different functions. From the last and the third video, we learned that what is data and how it is helpful in Python and why is data so powerful. So now I am with my new video and the title for it is Building Blocks of Python. I can also say it as it are the five major pillars on which coding is based on, not only for Python but for any of the computing language. So the five pillars or the building blocks of Python are keywords, identifiers, comments, indentation, and last but not the least, statements. So let's start with Python keywords. Keywords are the reserved words that serve a specific purpose and which cannot be used as an ordinary identifier. There are 33 keywords in Python language. As you can see, the list of all 33 Python language keywords are on your screen. So let me explain you one. Let me explain you if. The if keyword is used for comparison. For example, let's take example of a student. If you want a student to pass, he needs to get at least 35 marks or above that. So here the if keyword will come into action. Here we will write a code that if the student score is above or equal to 35 marks, then he is passed or else he is failed. So if serves a specific purpose of comparison or finding out whether it is true or false. Now, the second keyword that I am going to explain you is import. Import keyword is used to import packages like NumPy, Pandas, etc. See, I have imported NumPy as np. Here, if I run, it runs. Therefore, it shows that import is a keyword that is used to import packages and libraries. Now, let's come to our second pillar, that is identifiers. Identifiers, as its name suggests, it is used to identify like class, objects, functions, etc. in Python. Let's take an example. If you have hundreds of classes but you haven't named them, then how will you identify that which class is for what purpose? So here the identifiers come into action. They help you recognize or identify that which class is for what purpose. But identifiers have their own rules. Firstly, identify uses all three: uppercase, lowercase, and numeric values. Uppercase are letters from capital A to capital Z, whereas lowercase are letters from small a to small z, and numeric values, you all know, numbers 1, 2, till it's the limit. But identifiers do not use special characters like hash, @, dollar, etc. It uses only one special character, that is underscore. Now, identifiers, one more rule, that an identifier name cannot start with a number. You can use a number between identifier, but it needs to start with a letter. Keywords cannot be used as identifiers. So let me show you some identifiers by naming it. Here we go. So see, I have, let me type and show you. Look, I am writing a wrong identifier, like 3 Pujan equal to 10. Now if I run this, see, it's showing me an invalid syntax, but when I remove this and run it, it runs perfectly. Now you have seen that an identifier doesn't start with a numeric value, but you must be confused if it runs with special character or not. Now let me show you. Let me put Pujan at the rate 1, 2, 3 and enter it. See, it assigns that cannot assign to operator because special characters aren't we use. Whereas I remove this at the rate and then run it. See, it runs. This is that simple of how to know or write an identifier. Now let's come to our third important pillar, which is comments. Comments, it's like an unsung hero. It's the most important thing in coder's life. It's like, as I have told you in previous videos, that comments help you understand what code is going to tell you. It's like, for example, if you write a code of 100 lines and you run it and it runs perfectly, but you know till 1 week, but after 6 months, if you see this code, you wouldn't be able to understand what code is going to tell you. But when you write a comment on the side, it helps you understand that what code is trying to tell or what code is trying to run. It not only helps you in future, but it also helps other coders that sees your code and wants to understand what the coder tries to tell. Comments lines are ignored by compilers or interpreters, so comment lines are never run. If you want to write a comment, you have to put an hash at the start. Hashtag, anything that starts with hashtag are known as comments. Now, comments are of two types. Sorry, it came four. It are of two types. One is single line comment and multi line comment. So let me show you what are single line comments and multi line comments. My keyboard's a little slow. So here we go. Single line comment. See, here it's a single line comment. See, I have written a comment here. See, hashtag single line comment. Here also, when I've imported NumPy as np, see, I have put a comment here. Keyword import is used to import NumPy as a package. So here, whenever new person or a non-coder will read this import NumPy as np, he wouldn't understand what's this. But when he reads this, your keyword import is used to import NumPy as package. So you will understand here. Yes, here NumPy is being imported as package. So comments help you understand what the code is trying to tell you. But sometimes comments cannot come in single lines. It comes in multi lines. So yes, multi line comments are written between three single inverted commas or three double inverted commas. So you can write comment anywhere, but always make a habit that you have to write comments when you are coding. It helps you understand that how your code's going to work. So here was all about comment. Now it comes to the fourth pillar, that is indentation. Indentation is the way of presentation your code. Codes are not what you see in novels. It's not a single line of code. It needs to be presented. If you write in a single line, no coder will understand what the code is trying to tell you. But if you write it in a proper way, you will understand what the code is trying to tell you. In C, C++, Java, and many languages, we use braces for indentation. But here, we just use enter. So generally for indentation, we use 4 white spaces or 4 spaces. as we can tell. It makes, and the most important thing of indentation is that it makes your code readable and understandable. Now, let me show you how indentation works. So, indentation works like this. See, I have written same code in two different ways. See, here I have written var 1 equal to 10, var 2 equal to 20, and then I am trying to add both 2, but it's showing a syntax error. Whereas, when I have indented like var 1 10, then I have put an entered sign, then I have come to var 2 equal to 20, then I have come on the third line and print its value, then it's running it properly. So, indentation is the way of presentation and making a code readable to yourself as well as to the one that you are presenting. So, this was all about what is indentation and how does indentation look like. And here comes the last but not the least, the fifth pillar, Python statements. Python statements helps you execute. Helps interpreter execute what the code's trying to tell. A Python statement can be of two types, single line statement, multi-line statement. Examples of Python statement, if statement that I have explained to you in previous, while, for, etc. This we will be studying in our future videos. But single line comment and multi-line comments. So let me show you what is a single line comment and a multi-line comment. So, see, a single line comment is generally used to assign certain value. Here, var1 equal to 50. Here, I am assigning variable 1 with value 50. And it's a single line statement. So, this is a statement. Everything I have written here also in indentation, var2 equal to 20, which I have been written, is a statement. So, single line statements are generally used to assign values, whereas multi-line statements are used to get inputs. Like, see, I have written v underscore p here, input. Input is a keyword which is used to take input from the user. For example, like 100, we have entered marks of physics as 100, marks of chemistry as 80, and maths we will take as 92. So here I have written this as it's like I have written multi-line statement. So now you all know that what are five important pillars of Python. So now let's recall back what are the five statements. So the five statements are keywords, identifiers, comment, indentation, and statement. I would like that if you practice these keywords, identifiers, comments, indentation, and statements at your home after seeing this video in your Jupyter notebook, or while you can also do it while you are practicing with me as I was showing you. And I would like that if someone in my comment section tells me the different like what is the function of keyword false, none. If anyone does, it will be a great work and I would also appreciate it. So at the end, I will just say thank you and put a like button, share it as much as you can, and please subscribe it. My 50% of viewers haven't subscribed my video. Please, yeah, it feels good. And share it with your friends who likes coding or who wants to come into coding. Thank you. Stay safe. Bye, guys.